Good morning.
Flippin' physics.
Let's say we have two large charged plates of equal magnitude. The top plate has a positive charge and the bottom plate has a negative charge. In a previous lesson, we showed that the electric field between parallel plates is uniform and is directed from the positive plate to the negative plate, which is, in this example, directed downward. Let's say the electric potential difference between the two plates is 12 volts, and the distance between the two plates is 1.0 centimeters. Let's define the top plate as plate A and the bottom plate as plate B. If we release a proton from the inside surface of plate A, what will the speed of the proton be right before it runs into plate B? Bo, please solve this problem.
Sure. We can draw a free body diagram of the forces acting on the proton, sum the forces, solve for acceleration, and then use the uniformly accelerated motion equations to solve for the final speed of the proton. So, in the free body diagram...
Actually, Bo, you could certainly solve this problem that way. However, let's not solve it that way today. Could you instead use conservation of mechanical energy, please?
Okay. But how do we know mechanical energy is conserved in this example?
There is no work done on the proton by a force applied or by a force of friction, so mechanical energy is conserved.
So, mechanical energy initial equals mechanical energy final. Actually, let's do mechanical energy at plate A equals mechanical energy at plate B instead, because we already have those defined. At plate A, the proton has electric potential energy. However, it does not have kinetic energy because it starts at rest and there is no spring, so no elastic potential energy and gravitational potential energy. Does the proton have gravitational potential energy?
That is a good question. The gravitational potential energy for subatomic particles is usually negligible, and it is in this situation. You could prove it by comparing the change in gravitational potential energy of the proton to the change in electric potential energy of the proton. However, we're not going to take the time to do that today. So, typically for subatomic particles, gravitational potential energy is negligible, and you do not need to identify a horizontal zero line.
Sure. So the only type of mechanical energy the proton has at plate A is electric potential energy. At plate B, the proton has kinetic energy and electric potential energy. Subtract electric potential energy at A and kinetic energy at B from the whole equation. On the right-hand side, that equals the change in electric potential energy. We know electric potential difference equals change in electric potential energy over charge. That means change in electric potential energy equals charge times electric potential difference. Now we have negative 1/2 times mass times speed at B squared equals charge times electric potential difference. We can solve that equation for the speed of the proton at plate B, but we cannot take the square root of a negative number. As a proton moves in the direction of an electric field, it loses electric potential energy.
That means the electric potential difference in the direction of the electric field is negative.
Oh, yeah. I think I forgot that.
Yes, and sadly it is often forgotten. Bo, please substitute in numbers.
The charge on a proton is positive 1.6 times 10 to the negative 19 coulombs. The electric potential difference from plate A to plate B is negative 12 volts. And the mass of a proton is...
On the AP Physics C table of information, which we will get during the exam, it says that the mass of a proton equals 1.67 times 10 to the negative 27 kilograms.
And we get 47,952 meters per second, or 48 kilometers per second with two sig figs.
Whoa, that seems really fast. How fast is that?
Multiply by 3,600 seconds over 1 hour and 1 mile over 1,609 meters, and we get 107,288, or 1.1 times 10 to the fifth miles per hour.
Yeah, that is fast.
Yeah.
Yes, it is. Thank you very much for learning with me today. I enjoy learning with you.